Hey everyone, this is Farid, and welcome to the sixth part of my Let's Play, where we'll be doing the Scrap Brain Zone. Sorry that I haven't released a video in a while, I've been kinda busy with stuff, and trying to make this video and everything. Anyways, this is the Scrap Brain Zone, which is easily the hardest level in the entire game. Lots of machinery, lots of the old enemies return, including the Ball Hog, actually that's a new one, which is a pig that fires bombs, the Catkillers from Marble Zone, the bombs from Starlight Zone, the Burrowbots from Labyrinth Zone, and even the Orbinauts come back. Fantastic. So, in order to make this video entertaining, there are actually many, many different path branches for this zone, which is kind of interesting. So, I try to rush through it and take the topmost path to show you, like, what the best possible path would be. The bottom path's filled with a bunch of pits and electricity. This way has a bunch of hidden items, and it's kind of interesting. These platforms are kind of neat and all. Fun fact about the zone, you can find this background in Sonic Drift, which is a game that racing game I was talking about. It appears in the Sega Superstars Tennis, which is a tennis game on the 360 and PS3. And the music actually appears in Super Smash Bros. Brawl as an unlockable, which is kind of cool. The beta name for the zone was the Clockwork Zone. It was still meant to be the last, though. And this zone actually doesn't have a boss. It goes into the final zone, which will be in a later video, and that will be the final boss. So for now, we're just going to make our way through this. We only got one challenge this week, but that's fine, though. And that's going to appear in the third level, because the first levels of this are actually pretty difficult. These parts, if you don't go fast enough and don't roll, you will get squished, and that will instantly kill you. This level is not very forgiving. It's kind of insane. But it's also pretty fun. There's lots of path branches. Again, it's pretty fast. Got a lot of interesting puzzles. I don't know why I just ran into that thing right there. I guess I was being stupid. Whatever. And that was the first level. As usual, always get the points, because I love to get the points. You know, leaderboards and all that stuff. Hey, it's fun. Don't judge me. This is the second act, which goes inside. And now we're gonna be indoors. There's lots of these... Well, after I get past this flame and not be stupid, there's lots of these rotating wheels, which are kinda cool. You can run around them, build tons of momentum. You can actually roll up. You can roll into a ball and then launch yourself, which will create lots of momentum and get you to fire really far in the air, although it's less accurate that way. Again, I take the top paths because top paths are fun, except for the electricity, which is really rude and annoying, and hello, spike ball. Yeah, I get hit quite a few times in this level. I actually did a bunch of takes to get a good take, and this is the best one I had. So I apologize if I get hurt too much, but hey, I'll try and show you some cool tricks, like jumping off while rolling the ball. It's kinda neat and all. This zone also appears in Sonic the Comic, and I believe it appears in Sonic the Hedgehog. Or excuse me, Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog at some point. So it's a pretty popular zone. This part's insane. The platforms reset themselves depending on how you enter. But if you don't get a running start, you will be squished. Because in addition to platforms like that, there's conveyor belts which work against you, and there's electricity out of nowhere. It's really hectic, and it's kind of insane. And hey, Catkiller, remember the enemy that we hated from Marble Zone so much? Yeah, he's back here. Fantastic. Now down at the bottom there, there's an extra life, but it's surrounded by lots of electricity, so obviously I don't want to go for it. Saw blades are kind of annoying, including that one that came out of nowhere. Where the hell was that? I'm not even sure. Oh well. Let's keep going. Pit creatures are kind of annoying, which you may have seen earlier. The ball hogs. They fire balls, which you can't destroy, and they bounce around. But thankfully, they're pretty easy to dodge. And that was the end of the second zone. This is also the zone, excuse me, the second act. This is also the only act in the game where you can't get points by jumping off the checkpoints. And let's see what's happening here. What's this? Oh, we got like a cutscene of sorts. We're trapped behind a wall, Robotnik has a switch, and oh no, the platform's crumbling. No! And welcome to the third level, where we have a challenge from Jack Archer, which is to only tap the movement keys instead of holding them down. This basically affects Sonic's speed, although not necessarily while he jumps in the air. This particular act, as you may notice, is kind of like Labyrinth Zone. There's a lot of water, it's kind of long, also kind of annoying, so to save time and show you an interesting trick, you can actually roll by that bridge at the very beginning, that platform, and you get this major shortcut where as long as you don't fall down the pit, so you can basically skip like 2 minutes of this level. Pretty interesting secret, hope you guys find it useful. This challenge basically is kind of tricky because, again, you can only tap the buttons, and from what I've noticed, the programming seems to like reset Sonic's velocity like while he's on the ground every time you let go of the button, except for when he's in the air. And believe it or not, we are almost done with this, actually. In fact, we are. The next zone is the final zone. I will see you all there. Thanks for watching.